My name is Chantel Foster, and I am the Senior Director of Youth Social for Group M. And for those of you that are not aware of what paid social is, I'll be happy to explain it for everyone. But who doesn't love Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram?
Who does not
love
it? Who doesn't love it? Like, who absolutely loves it? Only two people here?
Oh, we all use it.
I know we all use it, but who loves it?
Oh, I mean.
Social media.
I could go without it, yeah.
Well, no, it's annoying now because every time you're on there, there's an ad that pops up.
Right.
Well, that's my job.
So
you are to hate me. Because when you go on an Apple site and you look at the latest phone, I'm going to make sure Apple pulls up all over every site, every screen you look at, until you buy that phone. Mm-hmm. So that's why I get paid a lot of money. My real first question to you guys is, what do you think every company in the world needs to be successful?
Money.
Yeah. Well, as the senior director for Group M, I would say a solid marketing plan and a strong leader. And that's what my role is. And I just wanted to explain a little bit about who Group M is. Group M is responsible for 1 in 3 ads that you see globally. So whether you're in your car, you're looking at your Spotify and an ad pops up, or you're on vacation in Bali, there's going to be an advertisement that's from my company. So we employ 27,500 people across the globe in 400 global offices in 81 countries. So it's a pretty large company. Great benefits, and I have the link here for you guys to apply because it's a great opportunity. So just some cool facts about Group M, besides the fact that they're so large, is that they started as a manufacturing company, and the owner, kind of like a Steve Jobs, he saw the vision of what advertising is. Advertising is what makes your product successful. So he started to buy out 18 Within their first 20 years, he started to just buy out advertising agencies. And you're talking about in the 1970s when a company maybe cost $500 million to buy, he bought them outright. So he owns like pretty much every advertising agency globally. So does anyone want to know what my day-to-day is like?
Yes.
I get to look at analytics, see who's looking at things, see if the team is working, and then deciding pretty much what campaigns are working, what's not working, how do we get Android to beat Apple, or Microsoft to beat MacBooks. So we're always thinking, we're always just coming up with creative ideas to take a company to the next level. So I would encourage everyone to apply if you're interested in being creative, if you're interested in marketing, if you're interested in building a product, because marketing is going to take your product to the next level. So I wanted to share this quote with you from our, he is the head of career development. So he says, to create advantage, you must know more about your consumers than your competitors or your media partners. And you have to be able to put this knowledge to work with your media investment. Our tech stack and data investment enables this knowledge chemistry for our clients. So, and then, to conclude, I want to let you know a little bit of what my skill set is to have this position. I'm a member of the American Marketing Association. I've worked 5 years in just media planning and media buying and working with different companies to see what the best strategies are. And I'm a creative and problem-solving oriented human being. So that's pretty much how I got the role. And to conclude, I wanted to share some cool facts about how digital marketing is growing and what people are spending money on. So Forbes estimates that in the US alone, by 2021, that $120 billion will be spent alone on digital marketing agencies' plans. So when a company wants to get to like an Apple or a whatever level, they have to have a strong marketing budget. So they have to really understand where to spend their money. So that's what we do, and that's why we have so many employees that will sit with you day to day, and come up with a plan to get your products seen. And then in 5 years, it's anticipated that 40% of all marketing budgets will consist of some digital advertising, whether it be social media, whether it be YouTube, or you know, pretty much anywhere that anyone looks, there's going to be a form of advertising. And right now, one cool fact, millennials like us now spend over $600 billion a year, and we're classified as the highest spending group. And so marketers know that the way to reach a millennial is through a Candy Crush game, or a, what's one of the latest games? I don't know. Okay, I think of Candy Crush because I used to play Candy Crush until all the ads started popping up, and then I said, it's too much. Or you pay for a paid prescription so that you don't get ads, such as Pandora. Who pays for Pandora? Nobody, right? Because you just, now they have the opportunity for you to skip an ad. If you look on YouTube, for instance, now they're putting ads in the middle of something you're watching, they're going to get to you. So, does anyone have any questions? Well, I'm in marketing, I think, my whole life, because I always think of a way, if you have a pen, for instance, how do you get that pen where you're going to take it home? It's free right now, so I don't think you'll take it home, but if I charge you $20 and told you this is the best pen in the world, most likely you'll think it's something that you need. Mm-hmm. So I think all of us are marketers. It's just, you just have to stay with technology and be in tune with what's going on with all the time. Any other questions?
Well,
marketing and sales are totally different. Like, sales to me is, I just sold you that pen because I told you it's great. Mm-hmm. A marketer has to design that pen to make you feel it's great and has to know what you're thinking. Like, why do you think this is a cool pen? Maybe because it has four different colors as opposed to a regular pen that has one color. Mm-hmm. So I have to think of you as what you would think is cooler than what somebody else has. That's why I think marketing and sales is a little bit different.
Mm-hmm. So you do just marketing or marketing and stuff?
My role is just marketing. So and it's just digital. It's not like I always say that if you wanted to reach a 20-year-old, you're not going to mail them a flyer. You're going to get on Spotify and you're going to play while they're listening to your favorite playlist. You got to somehow get in there. Mm-hmm. So that's the difference in what I do.
Thank you.